Welcome back to the Rope Access Channel. In this video, we will rescue that dummy. All right, so we have a very often requested video, and to be honest, this will be the third time I film this, because sometimes I don't do it properly and sometimes the microphones die, as you've heard in other videos. So what do we have today? A mid-transfer rescue, and it's a large rope-to-rope transfer. So I have my casualty up there, and he is suspended in an ID on this side and his ascender on this side. So he is moving from your left to your right. There's two options to do this rescue. I can either take him that way or that way. What we often say is it's the taking the casualty to the crawl side. That's the easy part, because then I don't have to do the chest ascender or the changeover of the casualty while in the transfer. But I think it's actually easier to do it in the transfer, because not his full weight is supported. But I will show you what we call the hard way. But before I will show you, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to always be updated for a new upload. All right, I have four ropes I can choose from, and there is a lot of theory about which one you should choose, but in real life, if this is 50 meters, I have no idea which rope is what. So I will just pick two and go up. All the gear up there, it's strong enough to support any possible load that a one person can put on it. But the ID, when it's loaded lengthways, looks really ugly. I will overlay the little footage I have of it. That's a test done by Richard Delaney. If you want to find a person with about the most knowledge and the most humble, Richard Delaney, go follow him. He has done the tests you see everybody doing right now. He did them 10 years ago. All right, so I will take two ropes, and because I can see, I will climb up as my main rope on his backup line. And my backup will be this one. That's the rope coming out of the chest ascender. So I'm going to have my backup on a device with teeth, which is not bad, because if I will load this suddenly, all that will happen is that the dummy will move a little bit to the side. It's the same as somebody ascending in a chest ascender. So I put my ASAP on, and I have no extra gear. I have my minimum setup with me, except maybe a little rescue set and a grillon. I'm not going to use the grillon, but the grillon is the get out of jail free card. Ooh, confused. So I will go up. Take out some stretch and up. And climb up easily. Adjust my harness a little bit so I have less sit back. If you want to know more about sit back and how to do this really efficient, you can watch the video up there about how to rope walk. But for now, I will just use the frog method. Right, I arrive at my casualty. First thing I'll do is change over to my descender. And I continue to climb up a little bit. So the first thing I need to do is get over my casualty. I need to pass him, and we're going to treat him like he's a couple of knots. So I make a new backup. If I have two backup devices, it would be great. I can just move it to this rope, but I don't have that. So I will tie a butterfly knot underneath my ASAP, put in a cowtail, So I have a backup here. I'm at full factor one, so very acceptable. I can move my ASAP above the casualty, remove the knot. So now I have made the first pass. I am almost above, completely above. Next step is I need to get rid of this ID or ASAP because I need to move up a little bit more. So in order to end, next step is I need to get this ID free. So we're going to work on the first part of releasing the casualty. I take my cowtail, make a long connection to the casualty, minding the ropes. So we'll go underneath and connect it to the top D-ring. That's one. Then I take my little rescue set, and this will be a little bit of a pull. And I will do it a little bit different than what we see usually. Because usually, we tend to connect the casualty to the top D-ring on everything. But if I do that here, with all the sideways movement, I will be pulling in a weird angle. So I will go into his bottom D-ring, which means I need to do some casualty management afterwards. But I will show you that in a minute. So, I'm checking the rope management, the path of the ropes. I connect the rescue set, the short connection. This could be three carabiners as well, or a piece of cowtail, whatever you tie. And I swing myself in, and I'm going to try to connect it in the carabiner of the Megawatt. So here we go, one, two, three, swing in, connect. I have my two connections to the casualty. That means I can get rid of this ASAP. And a nice little trick is, if I would undo this, it's sort of hard to do, but if I just take the ASAP off his harness, and now I can take it home with me. Now I've truly passed the casualty. I can't even go up more, so that's good. Next step is I need to get this ID out so I can change him over here. So, minding the ropes again, putting them on the outside, putting this red rope on the outside as well. I can just lower his ID out and he's suspended in me. Take out the rope. So now we are still in a large rope to rope transfer, but I'm on 2 points that way. He's on 2 points that way. I'm a little bit higher than him. So, and we have two connections between us. So next thing is I have a look at what his ASAP is doing on this side. Is it running freely or is it locked? And someone put it on lock, but it's probably me. So if I would forget this and lower out that way, I would could get into trouble, so I'll undo it right now that it runs freely. So that's one. And now I can put the rope coming out of his chest descender into his descender. I make the distance as short as possible. And now I will take, now I need to do a crawl rescue, and if you want to learn how to do that, you can watch it on the video up there. But a little bit sideways. So he has a nice little foot loop there, maybe I will use that. There are so many ways to do this. I don't need to use my own one. I make it longer. Go through the carabiner into his top D-ring. I'm going to measure the distance, because if it's too high, I cannot get my foot in. But I also have to lower him out a little, and my foot will end up there. I'm not that flexible. So, and if you don't do this right the first time, then you do it a second time. I think this should be okay. Now the trick is, I don't push up, but I push that way. If you have trouble with that, you can actually do a redirect here through a carabiner and push down. But I think I can manage this. So I step up that way and open the crawl and lower out controlled. So here we go, 3, 2, 1. Ah, it didn't work. So I put in more weight. I'm fully suspended. The crawl is open. I rope is out, I close the crawl. And as you can see, it's one finger I have my balance. So it doesn't really take that much strength or force to maintain this position. I squeeze the foot loop, I release slowly, and if it's too heavy, I might actually be turn it a little bit, so I create more friction, take my foot out, lower out slowly, and he is in his descender. We're getting closer. One thing to monitor, and what I did not mention, is that the length of this cowtail is quite important, because if I screwed up, then he's suspended in that ascender, and I would need to repeat this process, or ascend him up, or figure out something. But I was lucky, so I'll take it. Clean up some more stuff. Make sure that all the ropes are... Oh, I made an error, I'll tell you in a minute. So that you don't get confused, clean it up. Underneath. So what did I do? How do I show you? So the rope coming out of his descender is in between my short connection and my cowtail. Not a big deal. I can solve that because I have more cowtails and connections left. So I will make a new connection temporarily, and I move my long cowtail in such a way that there's nothing in between, like this. I put that long connection back. And now it's over his ASAP, but that's not so bad. I will have a look at the system, and in all my struggles, this one went down, so I just put it up a little bit. And now we're ready to move that way. This one, descender, the rope is in threaded properly. His ASAP is moving up and down the rope, so I can just descend that way. I don't need an extra friction point for this because there is hardly any weight going that way. So slowly going that way until he comes into me. I keep him to my side, because if I keep him to my side, it's easier for me to undo the ID. If I would take him in between me, then it would be a little bit harder. I take out the rope of the descender, or the ID. I'm done with that, so get rid of it. I'm done with this one. Get rid of that. And now, if this would be a live person, let me twist a little bit. If this would be a live person, then he would be unconscious. He would be really falling back down. So I need to manage my casualty. So I take one extra carabiner. I will steel hit off his cowtail. And I will see where I can connect it. It's always hard, and you have to sort of see which way to orient it. I will put it like this, and then maybe I can get it in there. Okay, let me see if I can show you. So I take a top D-ring, and I'm going to try to put it in the top carabiner of the rescue set. I can use my... When you practice this with people, it's easier, because they automatically go like this. I can use a sort of a swinging motion to clip it in, I hope. 1, 2, 3, and it's in. Hey, let me turn. Here we go. So there's one more thing to do, but I will tell you after I tell you about where we're filming this beautiful video. So So right now we're an industrial climber in Wormerveer in the Netherlands, and you can come here for all the training you need with regards to working safely at height. We provide GWO training, IRATA training, working at height training. We train rescue teams, there's fire awareness, all the good stuff that you need. There's a web store and a physical store in IJmuiden, pretty close by, and we have all the latest gear. If you are interested in that, visit www.industrialclimber.nl. Link will be in the description. And if you use my code, you get a nice little discount and you support the channel. And they ship worldwide, so that's a good thing too. Another way to support the channel is by heading over to www.patreon.com/theropeaccesschannel. And you can sign up for the level one tier, and then every time I release a new educational video, then it's basically you go sit down, drink your own cup of coffee, and you buy me a cup of coffee. So those are a couple of ways you can support the channel. To finish off the move, I need to go down, but it's very important if you go down that you remove your hand ascender. And depending on the device you are using, rope management more, you may need a extra friction carabiner on your descender. So with this Megawatt, I do need one. And if you want to learn the finer details about the Megawatt and my thoughts on it, you can watch this video up here. A full review after 2 months of use, and I've had some more months on it by now, and I really like it. It's a great device. So on my way down, I will check that all the ropes are free, nothing is in the way. I checked that the ASAP moves down, so that's good. And I will go like this on the Megawatt. A lot of friction, slow and controlled. And while we will go down, I'll tell you, I will see you in the next one. Stay connected. Yeah!